Sure. Okay. So again, so when it has the minus 6 back here, that minus 6 is okay. It's up and down move. So mathematically, I could just put a minus 6 at the end and then do that. 5 minus 6 is negative 1. And this is the actual answer. You don't have to draw a picture. This is the answer. Now, if I do look at the picture and I move it down 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I see that it sure enough does end up right there at negative 1. Okay? Questions on that one? All right, number 2. Okay. So this is a linear function. Probably you can't see it on this side. This is a linear function f of x. We're going to write g of x, which takes f and performs a vertical shrink on it. So stresses and strains come into play right here in the A spot. I want to show you a slide that really, as you're doing the big ideas and as you're preparing for your quiz, you should have memorized this. And if not memorized yet, it will help you to remember it. There it is. You guys remember writing these 6 bullet points down? This is what I'm using to do this. So when it says to do a vertical stretch, I gotta go back to my notes.
Translate, translate, reflect, reflect. Vertical stretch, how do we do it? Oh, multiply entire equation by A. This of 1/2 is the A value.
Okay.
So you're gonna do this enough to where those bullet points are memorized.
So if you're not memorized yet, you need to take a picture and study it. You know, look at it between classes to remind yourself. What I would do is I would have written this down, and then I would cross out the ones I know by heart, and then I would kind of circle the ones I don't know, and then
write
I would
down,
write it off 3 times, and that's how I remember things.
Wait, so the answer is
yeah. Okay, so I have to distribute 1/2 into this whole thing.
Yeah, maybe you think about it as dividing it by half.
So to do it, I multiply the whole thing by A. So I put A, that's the 1/2 outside, and I multiply it in. 1/2 times 2 is 1x, and 1/2 times 8 is 4. So our new function, g of x, is x minus 4.
Like
Asking me is here. This is the F function. Notice even though it says plus 3 that it's over here to the left. So this is F of X. Now I want to reflect it across Y. And all you have to do is put a negative sign right in front of X and it'll. And there it goes. It flipped across. Okay? So the moves work. And if you're questioning what I used to question this, yeah, right. It also says we gotta go down 5. So to go up or down, you just gotta put that number at the end. So I just gotta put a minus 5 in, and now it's down. So that's the answer for number 3. Okay, ready for number 4 then? Who's got a good question? Anybody?
Yeah.
No. It'll be the power quiz is after the chapter test. So there's like 3 more sections in chapter 1 or something. We're gonna do a whole 100-point test. So you take a quiz tomorrow, it's gonna be worth like 30 points. In another 2 weeks, you'll have a test. Where you get asked all the same questions again with another 15 and it'll be worth 100 points. Quiz versus after the test is the best quiz. Okay, number 4. I just thought you had a different number for that. What's your question over here? Not this quiz, but as the year goes on, I do start to allow for open notes, but I put a cap on that grade. So if you're struggling in every quiz test you take and you haven't gotten over a C, I'll say, you know what, use your notes this time, but I cap you at an 80. Or sometimes I cap you at a 70. Maybe you're struggling to pass. I say use your open notes, use your book, but the highest you can earn is a 70. So if you've been getting D's, you're really happy to get up to 70. But if you've gotten, mid to high B's, and you're getting A's, you shouldn't be using a notes in a book. So if that's your goal and that's your ability level, no notes in a book for you. But if you're like, man, I don't get this topic, I didn't study, can I just use my notes this time? Fine. But you won't earn higher than a 70. Okay? Everybody hear that? Okay. But I'm going to wait, because you want to see how you can do before you. So probably around the second quarter. I'll start to learn open notes on quizzes. Oh, you passed the ASMR? Straight up. Okay, so. I'm still. As a vertical stretch of 3, then a horizontal. Translation. Sorry, I got distracted. Anybody else in the room? Okay. Right number 4, everybody. We have a quadratic or parabola. Okay. get points for setting three up correctly. No big deal if you didn't think you need a bracket, but generally, if there's already parentheses, the next set is brackets. No big deal. Doesn't matter. But now, actually distributing correctly is, you know, it takes practice as well. So when I distribute, I'm going to put a 3 here, and I'm going to multiply a 3 by there. I can't go and put a 3 here, and then also in the parentheses. Oh, and that's because I'm going to FOIL this at some point and then distribute. And so if I put the 3 here and here, it's like actually multiplying by 9. That might be way too much words for you right now.
Just know that the 3 is going to land outside the parentheses and it goes all the way to the 4. So that's my vertical stretch. Now I have to go horizontally 5. So anything horizontal is supposed to show up in parentheses. So from the 2, I want to go left 5 more. So I'm going to, it's funny because it's left, so I'm going to add. Sorry. Yeah, left, technically left we think negative 5. Yeah, think about left. Let me draw you another one.
Well, then you're all the way in this lesson already. So this is 0. Left is typically negative 5. So if I want to go left, I put a plus 5 in. And it was, thank you. All right, let's see if we turn this into 7, if it works. It's minus 12 now, isn't it? So even though we put a plus 5, it went left. We're doing big ideas right now, so we're gonna log in and do big ideas. If you're done big ideas, I'm gonna give you a
I'm sure.